Hello students, today we will discuss the play R.B. Sheridan's The School for Scandal. Let us first look at who R.B. Sheridan is. Richard Brinsley Butler Sheridan is an Irish writer. He was born in Dublin, Ireland in 1751 and he died in London, UK in 1816. This particular play, The School for Scandals, is a comedy of manners and it was published in 1777. The other books of Sheridan are The Rivals, Sir Patrick's Day, The Duenna, A Trip to Scarborough, The Camp, The Critic, and Pizarro. Let us look at the main characters in this particular play. Oliver Surface is the uncle who stays in East Indies for 16 years and returns home. He wanted to shift his heirship to one of his nephews, either Joseph Surface or Charles Surface. Now, Charles Surface is in love with Maria and they are about to be engaged. But their engagement breaks because of the rumors spread against Charles. It is Lady Sneerwell and her servant Snake who spreads this rumor. There are other members in that gossip monger group and one of them is Lady Teazle. Lady Teazle has recently married the old bachelor Peter Teazle. Now that you've got familiarized with the main characters, I will move ahead with something, a small point to think about the title of the play, The School for Scandal. Now, what is the difference between rumor and scandal? Now, rumor is a temporary insult. No, somebody is charged with something very bad, no, something that hurts their reputation. Now, scandal is on a serious note. Now, it is something that remains there forever, and it keeps popping up every time a person's name is said. So now you find that this scandal is something with higher intensity, whereas rumor doesn't have any substance. Now, why is this drama named School for Scandal? Now, we find that there are characters here like Lady Sneerwell, Lady Teazle, then we have Mrs. Kendall, Sir Benjamin Backbite, and Sir Crabtree, who all fall under this group of gossip mongers. They keep gossiping, they spread rumors, and that plays a very important part in this particular drama. So Sheridan is attacking the contemporary society which is filled with such gossip mongers. So he has titled his play School for Scandal, The School for Scandal. Right, so in a drama, what are the questions that we normally ask? Now, when we read a short story or a drama or a novel, we have somebody who leads in this particular text. So, for example, if you have a movie, you have the stars like, the Tamil stars, cine stars like Ajit or Surya, who leads the particular movie. So like that, who is the main character in this particular drama? What happens to that main character? Is there something which is very difficult to achieve? Now, is there any problem for this particular character? Does the problem intensify or does it get solved easily? If it gets intensified, then how does it get resolved? So these are some of the questions that we should look when we read a drama or maybe a fiction. Now, here are our answers with respect to the play, The School for Scandal. Now, the main character here is Charles Surface. His engagement with Maria is stopped because of the rumors. Now, the important hurdle is that his financial need is very important because he is completely dependent on his uncle, and the uncle is yet to decide the heirship. So he is, as of now, not spending all the money gambling, and he has a lot of friends around. So his financial need is of much significance. And also, now he is involved in certain rumors with a woman. And as I told you earlier, it is Lady Sneavel who spreads this rumor. So he has to change or come out of this particular rumor. So only then he will have a flawless character. Now, he is also declared, Lady Sneavel has declared her love for Charles Surface, and he is also confused at this because all this proclamation happens in front of Maria, whom he loves sincerely and whom he wants to marry. And finally, somebody comes and helps him out. So who is this angel? So he is none other than Sir Rowley. Sir Rowley helps Oliver, and Oliver tests these two nephews, Charles Surface and Joseph Surface. So Oliver decides that Charles is still a good man, very noble in character. And therefore, you find Sir Rowley taking an effort in clarifying all the flaws or the rumors that were dumped on Charles. So Sir Rowley brings the servant of Lady Sneavel, Snake, to confess, and he even gives her double the money to tell the truth. So these are the characters in this particular play. So we earlier found some of the major characters. You must be familiar. Now these are the other characters. Lady Teazle, Lady Sneavel, Sir Peter Teazle, Joseph Surface, Mrs. Kendor, Sir Oliver Surface, Maria, Charles Surface, Rowley, Sir Benjamin Backbite. Charles Surface has fallen in love with Maria. Joseph Surface, in order to settle in his life because he needs money and Maria is a rich girl, he also wants to marry Maria. There is another person who also dotes his love on Maria, that is Sir Benjamin Backbite. There is Sir Harry Bumper, who is a friend of Charles Surface. Crabtree is the uncle of Sir Benjamin Backbite. Trip is the servant of Charles Surface. Then you have Snake, the servant of Lady Sneavel. Moses is a moneylender who accompanies Oliver when he disguises as a moneylender. And finally, Careless, even another friend of Charles Surface. As the name signifies, most of these characters are named according to their quality or their nature. Now, Oliver Surface, as I told you earlier, he is the uncle of Charles and Joseph Surface. He had been in East Indies for 16 years and he returns home. So to Charles, he disguised himself as Premium, Mr. Premium, a moneylender, and he appears along with Moses, another moneylender, who had been offering help to Charles Surface. So when Charles Surface asks Mr. Premium to take away all the portraits, family portraits, Premium, he is in disguise actually. He is Mr. Oliver Surface. So he, as aside, would say why this fellow is selling all the family portraits. I had good opinion on him, and look at him, he is ruining all the image. So this you will find in the textual analysis later. And to Joseph, Oliver Surface disguises as a poor relative and calls himself as Stanley and asks for help, and Joseph declines. And added to it, Joseph says, that the uncle gives him nothing. So, no, this hurts Oliver. He feels he had been helping these two nephews all this while, and there is no love for him from Joseph's surface. So, yeah, here is a small textual bit to find out, who is Noble and what are these two brothers up to. So, as I told you in the beginning, Charles Surface is, talked about a link or a relation with some other woman, and that is what breaks the engagement between Charles and Maria. So it is a rumor. So there is a screen scene where Joseph and Maria, they are in a room, and Joseph proposes Maria. Just then Lady Teazle enters. She sees the posture of Joseph bending before Maria and catches him red-handed, but he gives a very good excuse that he has only had concern over Maria and did not want to marry Maria. And Lady Teazle sends Maria out of that room. And when Joseph convinces Lady Teazle, there's somebody at the door, and that is none other than her husband, Peter Teazle. So she goes and hides behind the curtain. And you find Peter Teazle entering the room, and he would talk about the concern over the rumors that spread across his wife. So he is uneasy because his wife is rumored about. She is very young and he is very old. So he wanted to know whether Charles Surface is behind his wife or not. Just then Charles Surface comes. So before he could enter, Peter Teazle understands that it must be Charles. So he just goes and tries to hide in the room. So as he was trying to find a hideout, he sees that some woman is behind the screen. And then he thinks that that is Joseph must be with some other woman. And then he goes and he hides in a closet. So now Charles comes, and Charles is about to answer to the question of Joseph that there is somebody, there's some rumor regarding Charles Surface and Lady Teazle. So, Joseph is clarifying, and Charles replies, "I always understood you were her favorite." So you find Charles talking about Lady Teazle, that Lady Teazle is Joseph's favorite. So he's making clear that Charles has nothing to do with Lady Teazle. And Peter Teazle, who is hearing this, he understands that Charles is not the man who is connected with Lady Teazle. And when Charles says that it is Joseph who is her favorite, Peter Teazle doesn't doubt Joseph, because he has full faith on Joseph and he wanted Joseph to marry Maria. So with that, Peter Teazle has cleared his mind, and he has no doubt about the affair between Lady Teazle or any other man, which he first assumed to be Charles. So now the difference of opinion was clarified. Meanwhile, it is Lady Teazle who was behind the screen. And Lady Teazle understands the love of Peter Teazle when he was discussing about his life with Joseph. So even before Charles enters, Lady Teazle has cleared all her difference in opinions with her husband, and she decides to stay with her husband. Now, the second part of the screen, you will find Joseph talking to Lady Teazle. So this is as soon as the scene opens, when Joseph is caught red-handed by Lady Teazle, he gives an excuse to Lady Teazle that Maria, he was only showing some concern. And Sir Peter is suspicious about it. So you find Joseph trying to manage the relation between both Maria and Lady Teazle. In a sense, he is behind both women. So he wanted to extend his affair with both the women. So you find how Joseph is pretentious, whereas Charles is straight, and you find he is noble and he is noble. Now moving on to the couple. Now very interesting couple, Peter Teazle and Lady Teazle. Peter Teazle always fights with his wife Lady Teazle. He says, "I married with caution." So in the textual analysis, we will see how his marriage happened. So he had chosen a country bred girl like Lady Teazle, but after marriage, she wanted to lead a luxurious life. So that is where these two, the husband and wife, started fighting. Now, we will look at the gossip mongers, Ladies Nearwell, Mrs. Candor, Sir Benjamin Backbite, and Mr. Crabtree. So, here in this particular, after the screen scene, what the gossip mongers talk about them is how the fight between Charles Surface and Peter Teazle did not stop with words, but went ahead with swords, and then the swords became pistols. So this is how the gossip develops. Right, so here is a short video which I would like you to watch. This particular video is created by my student and it discusses the theme. Yes, so I will just move this video and freeze it. Yeah, so this is where you find the gossip becoming an important theme in this particular play. Lady Nearwell is the president. Yeah, marriage is another theme. So you find Lady Nearwell being a wealthy widow. She wanted to marry Charles. Charles wanted to marry Maria because he loves her. Peter Teazle wanted to marry a girl, young country bred girl, Lady Teazle, after so many years. So marriage is next is gender equality. Already we have seen how there is the husband wife fighting all the time. Peter Teazle trying to dominate over Lady Teazle. Yes, so you find there is parenting also one of the themes of this particular drama. Charles and Joseph, they are not properly guided. Appearance matters, the physical appearance. The play opens in the dressing room of Lady Nearwell. So you find these pretensions. Joseph is pretending in front of everybody as though he is noble and good. But when Oliver comes as Mr. Stanley, you find the true color of Joseph. So even Oliver tries to appear with disguises. So these all come under the appearance. We can even include Lady Teazle's desire, go for fashionable dresses. So this particular video was created by my student Santosh, and he is a YouTuber, and his video skills, creative skills, can be seen through the first half of it. Another theme in this particular drama, it is about wealth. So you find Lady Teazle, she wishes to lead a luxurious life, so she keeps pestering her husband Peter Teazle. Joseph Surface is after money, that is why he wanted to marry Maria. Charles Surface, he spends money and doesn't care about saving money. So you find Oliver, he is sending money to both his nephews when he was in East Indies. So Lady Sneerwell, she is a wealthy widow. So wealth there. Peter Teazle, he is ready to give a large amount, to settle things with his wife and get separated. Moses here is a money lender, and Maria is rich. So we have seen these themes in our videos. So gossip is one of the themes, or rumors is one of the themes. You can see official channel and unofficial channel. So official channel here refers to the gossips that are there printed in the newspapers. Unofficial is just word of mouth. Then marriage is another theme. Gender inequality. Here we found gender bias between Peter Teazle and Lady Teazle. Parenting and how family plays a part in this particular drama. Politics and power, we can even connect it with the gender bias, how there is the wealthy noble people, they are dominating, whereas you find some good characters like Maria, very submissive, not speaking much. So there is politics, the social class divisions, all that is seen in this particular play. Appearance, physical appearance of course matters much, and finally wealth. Yes, so we will move on to the textual analysis. This particular picture is drawn by one of my students, Jay Shweta, and here she talks how Lady Sneerwell talks about her experience, bitter experience, which she had in her life, and why she is now heading the gossip mongers. So you find this in the very beginning of the play. The first scene is in her dressing room, and this is how it starts. That is soon after the prologue. Yeah, so moving on to the textual analysis. So you find Rowley talking about Charles, how he can be corrected in his life, how his life can have some turn of events. Whereas Peter is only, biased, he only supports Joseph Surface, and he doesn't give preference for Charles Surface. So, no, he thinks that if Oliver gives away his money, his property to Charles, then his friend Oliver would be wasting his life. Yeah, so next is Peter Teasel's problem because he is married at a very late part of his life, and how he had cautiously, earlier when I was discussing about Peter Teasel and Lady Teasel, I've told you how cautiously he planned to get a girl, a country bred girl, but after marriage, Lady Teasel changes her likes and she now likes to lead a luxurious life. So you can see extravagant fopperies of fashion. So extravagant fopperies of fashion. Now how? Now she is after money just to suffice the fashionable life or the luxurious life that the wealthy social class, the high class, demands. And he is also sneered by people. He is also paragraphed in newspapers. So you can find the gossip mongers talking about him. I doubt I love her. It's a very serious statement. He says, I doubt I love her. So he is trying to get separated from Lady Teasel. Yeah, so this is another meme created by one of my students, Dinesh, and he is talking about gender bias. So you find Peter Teasel on one side asking his wife, Lady Teasel, won't you obey? And Lady Teasel gives a reply. Now this is on gender inequality. She says, if you wanted me to obey you, you should have adopted me as a daughter, not married me as and made me wife. Okay, so how gossip develops and how it delivers. Now, this is very interesting when we read the text of School for Scandal. So here, Sir Benjamin, Mrs. Candor and Lady Sneerwell. These are the three characters who keep discussing. Look at the highlighted words alone. One person says he was the lover. Another person says Peter's own. Another person says they fought. So in order to understand this, I'm just giving you a pictorial representation of how the gossip develops. So these are the four characters. Have an eye on these characters. The first one is Benjamin Backbite. He is the one who is behind Maria to get married. Next is Mrs. Candor and Lady Sneerwell. The one with the pen is Lady Sneerwell. You can very well remember Shweta's hand-drawn picture. And then Mr. Crabtree. Yeah, so the dialogue begins like this. Now they are talking about who is the person connected with Lady Teasel. So I had already briefed you what is that screen scene. After the screen scene, these people, the gossip mongers, are extending the story. So they are expanding it. Now he says, I think it is Mr. Surface. He is referring it to Joseph. And Mrs. Candor says, no, Joseph is not connected with Lady Teasel. It is Charles who is connected with Lady Teasel. Immediately, Lady Sneerwell is shocked because she had good opinion on Charles. So she is shocked. She says, Charles, is that Charles? And Mrs. Candor is giving an explanation. She says, Charles is the lover of Lady Teasel and Joseph is the informer. And the dialogue, it develops and you find the idea shifts to Peter's wound. How did he get wound? So here he refers, Backbite refers to a wound. And you find Lady Candor, Lady Sneerwell asking what wound? I'm so sorry, it is Candor asking what wound? And Lady Sneerwell says, I didn't even hear about the wound. And Benjamin says, what? You didn't hear about his wound? And Candor says, no. And he says, Charles and Peter fought. And therefore, Peter has a wound. Now, what did they fight? See, all these things never happened. I already told you, Peter was cleared of all the doubts when Charles said, Joseph, you are Lady Teasel's favorite. You remember we had a textual analysis? So you find Charles and Peter never fought. But these gossip mongers extend or expand that idea. So Crabtree enters and he says, yes, they fought with pistols. So this is how, you know, you find the gossip developing and being delivered. Now Charles, you know, he is being visited by Oliver when he comes in disguise. So Oliver comes as Mr. Premium along with moneylender Moses, and he is about to offer him money, and Charles is, you know, ready to give all the family portraits, great uncles, aunts, grandfathers, great grandmothers, all the pictures he wanted to sell off to Mr. Premium and get some money. So his only desire is to have some good money. So he wanted to give this paintings to somebody who has taste for paintings. Now look at the words of Oliver. Now I give him up. Aside. Now this is aside. No, this is a literary device which we often find in dramas. In the stage, you find a character, you know, talking in aside, which means it's information given to the audience, not to other characters. So now I give him up here signifies that Oliver had good opinion on Charles. And now when Charles is ready to give away all the family portraits, he's giving up his hope on Charles. So he says, do you take me for Shylock in the play? So here there's a reference to Shakespeare's Merchant of Venice, where the moneylender, the Jew, Shylock, asks for Antonio's flesh and blood. So that reference is quoted here. You can, go to any of these animated videos, or if you have done this particular play in your plus two, please refresh your memory and find out how or who Shylock is and how he asked for flesh and blood from Antonio. So that is referred here. Yeah, so there is a scene where, the last scene where Lady Teazle accuses Lady Sneerwell. And why I want this discussion to be brought in is to give you the answer for some, to a question which we already asked. So one question was on the difference between rumor and scandal. The next question was, why did Sheridan use title this drama as School for Scandal? So here, Lady Teazle says, I don't want your diploma. I don't want to have a practice. I'm giving off everything. I don't want to practice here anymore. I don't want to learn here anymore. You being the president of this scandalous college, you had been writing letters and you had been replying them. And you are killing others' characters. I am sorry, I can't be in this particular group, she says, and she quits. So you find, you know, how Lady Teazle turns to be a very good character later. So there's a transition in that character. Yeah. So this is my assignment to you, my dear students. You can pick anything to you can write a pictorial dialogue like how I have given you in the sample. So you can just go back to these samples, all those illustrations. Some of the contributions from your class is only put here, presented here to give you an idea of how to answer these assignments. I hope you understood the play. Thank you. Happy learning!